see we get to the end, but that's where we begin. You feel it? Mannequins, and we breaking the mold. Breaking out, and we breaking the codes. Similar to the jack who stole, to the depths in your wet, so your tank explodes. So get it out, send your body to flight. Everybody got a target tonight. Everybody come along for the ride. All your studs and your duds and your ladies is fly. Grip the moment like you're gripping the earth.
What's going on YouTube? This is JoezMcfly hitting you up with another reaction video to yet another Yankee game. And the Yankees once again were able to work out another win today again. Now, that's the great news. The bad news is that the freaking Red Sox won 1-0 against the Orioles that cannot score anymore. I don't know what's going on with those guys. But all you can do is just try to play your best baseball. That's the best thing that you can be able to do, because the Yankees don't play the Red Sox again. You already played them for all the times that you did. You were supposed to play them, and that's it. So, but let's get to the game, man, because it was just an awesome job. And by the way, update real quick on the Q&A. The Q&A, I'm going to go ahead and do it tomorrow morning, because it's this point in time is 1:30 in the morning. The reason why it took me so long to make this video after the Yankee game is just because I was actually doing my website, which I'm very excited for, and I'm going to put the link right here somewhere, and you guys can actually go there and get these hats. Got all sorts of different kind of hats there that you can be able to get and purchase there from the website. Try to make it really easy for everybody so you don't have to try to hit me up personally to try to get a hat if you did want one. But in the game today, first of all, CeCe's on the mound, and you guys know how I feel about CeCe. I do trust that guy. I think he's a big game pitcher, and I have a lot of confidence in CeCe. And you know what? It did not start well, because it was a leadoff hit, and then a bunt, which he hates, and then another bunt, and then another bunt. And it was crazy. Then before you know it, his base is loaded, and it's no out. You're like, oh shit, what the hell? So then CeCe ends up getting out of that situation with only giving up one run. And then he ends up giving up another run, which is a home run later on. But that's it for the Twins. Ends up keeping them there. The Yankees go on today to score 5 runs. But you know what? It's more about how they scored those 5 runs that I love. And they were getting, you know, they were doing things. They're getting 2 out hits. They were getting sac flies, which, by the way, the sac fly is underrated. They were doing things. They're getting sac flies. They were doing, you know, little things. Gardner had a big day today. He had 3 base hits, I believe, and 2 RBIs. Those 2 RBIs that he had, he worked Jose Berrios to the, it was 2 out hits, runners on base, and he worked good counts. I thought the Yankees had an awesome approach. In these last 2 days, the Yankees lineup has had an awesome approach when it comes to facing the starting pitching, which is working counts, really getting into the, you know, into the game, watching and looking at a lot of pitches, getting good solid contact, and it was good. I thought it was a great job by Judge today. Also, he got a sac fly also, and I thought he had some really good contact today, just all around. I mean, it was just a overall great team win. I like how the Yankees are now trying to incorporate more speed, which with Ellsbury and with Gardner, they're being more aggressive on the base paths, and they're stealing. I don't know if it's because of the catchers. And you know what? Let me talk about the catchers. For people that want to complain about Gary Sanchez as a catcher, you need to look at the Minnesota Twins catching situation. These 2 days, they had catchers that had to pass balls, wild pitches. They can't throw anybody out. So please, just be quiet about Gary Sanchez's defense, because he's only 23 years old, and at least he's still developing into something else. He can become better than what he is right now. So just stop dumping on Sanchez, man. It's just a lot of people just really love to do that, and even in unfair situations. But CeCe gave us 6 strong. Awesome job today. I was surprised Joe Girardi even let him go out there again. But CeCe went back out there, followed by Chad Green, D-Rob, And then, of course, we had Chapman. Chapman had another great inning, and his numbers in September have become Chapman-like. This is the Chapman that I remember. This is the Chapman from last year. And you know what? If it took us all the way till September to finally get Chapman, at least we got him back. And that's what I'm excited about. Now let's get Dellin straight so we can get Dellin back. And if we get Dellin back, then that's it. And let's get Adam Warren healthy. And then, you get what I'm saying? The Yankees right now, their magic number is officially 5 now, because the Yankee win, it was 7 when it started today. Yankees won, brought it down to 6. The Angels just lost to the freaking Cleveland Indians today, and the magic number actually went down now to 5. Yankees still obviously have their sights set on the division. There's 2 things that I wanted to address. The first thing is that when it comes to a tie, I said before in a video, and I was confused because of, situations before of a tie, that what would happen is that the Yankees would then win the division and that's it. However, I was wrong. If the Yankees tie the Red Sox, what would happen is that the Yankees would then have home field advantage and they would have to play a game 163 at Yankee Stadium, because the Yankees won the head-to-head matchup. So they would have to play a game 163 at Yankee Stadium, and then that would determine what would happen. So that would throw a serious monkey wrench, but that would be a good problem to have, but that would throw some serious monkey wrench in the whole situation. Right now, the Red Sox just won't lose. They won't lose. Let's be very honest here. They just will not lose. I said the Yankees had to go 15-6, and they might just go 15-6, and they still might not do it, because the Red Sox are playing at the same clip that the Yankees are playing. So it doesn't really matter right now. So let's see what happens there, man. Hopefully the Red Sox start losing a bit, but they're facing Cincinnati next. So let's see what happens there. But the second thing that I wanted to talk about is that I did say in earlier videos also that it was a great job by Girardi taking Severino out of this and going into, so that the Twins don't get a chance to see him. However, Joe Girardi rethought the whole situation and he said, you know what, we haven't clinched anything. We're still trying to go after the AL East. And you know what, by me putting Severino on Wednesday, we can be able to get 3 starts out of Severino versus only having him for 2. So I understand what he's doing there. You know what, if Severino's on, it doesn't matter how many times you really see him, honestly, because he's that nasty. He's that type of pitcher. And if you put him out there and they see him, so fucking what? Because they might see him again on that wild card Tuesday and they still might get shut down by Severino. So it doesn't really matter, because Severino's a really good pitcher. He's not out there like just throwing junk or just trying to trick you or whatever it is. He is going to, he's a dominating pitcher. So it's fine. I'm fine with the whole situation. It's not a problem. So that's what's going to happen there. But guys, make sure you guys do visit the website, which is www.pinstripesstrong.com, and go over there, order your hats. I'm going to start putting up my videos up there. Maybe I'm going to start doing some blogging on there also. So it's going to be a really exciting website. I'm going to see if I can be able to grow it a little bit more. Just remember, it's www.pinstripesstrong.com. So as I always say, man, if this is your first time on the channel, make sure you do click a like, click the subscribe also to get all of your Yankees videos, news, notes, reactions, all of that stuff. And as I always say, make sure you do keep your pinstripes on and keep them strong. Severino out there tomorrow going for the sweep. And then the Yankees now have won 6 straight series, playing their best ball of the season right now. 17 games over .500. Just doing a great job. So let's go Yankees, man.